believe we could start right there, and that could finish up your show today. If is a clause. An if clause. Belief is a thought you've been thinking for a long time. So allow a repetitive notion to become in your mind's eye a thought, and then it will be manifested in your reality. Period. Every single time, without further exception. So if that's the crashing of an economy, an earthquake, everyone's dying, everything's coming up roses, everybody's happy over there, whatever the thought is, that will be soon your reality. That's what happens. And then the contrast that you then create to stir up, to see how sweet the chocolate is, get past and beyond all that. Then what happens is you start realizing that there is a bit of co-creation going on. Here's a simple, easy thing. You're all individual human creators, God, if you were. And if you want to accept that, great. If you want to be less than that, that's your choice. You're so free. You can choose bondage. But if you get bent past and beyond all that, then what happens is you start realizing that there is a bit of co-creation going on. Just like those who are have a resonance with our work. It's very wonderful and very delicious. You see, you all have non-physical. And that's whether you know it or not, or like it or not, or want it or not. You have non-physical. Your very own non-physical. Your very own, we would say it would be interesting to call it a higher self when you ignore it 99.99% of the time. Why are you going to have to go to all the trouble to have a higher self and then ignore it? But please yourself, but ask the question, we'll answer them, it's no problem. But the dynamic of this interaction, if you have a resonance regarding this fun, because it is fun, life is supposed to be fun. And you make it so hard and all these issues and problems, and then your left hand can't figure it out, then you're mad. Then they're sending you worms on the lookie box and the pea pods and corrupting you and all these things and stuff. And it's like, wow, we gotta navigate all this stuff. We don't. But if you're interested in your higher self, play with it a little bit. Engage it. Start taking your power. Start coming into your place of power and knowing that the winds and the waves do indeed obey your will. And when you get crossways with something, relax and allow with a contract, and that's what gives you the new defining process of your new realizing of a manifestation, or we call it a creation, in your world. And here's all you gotta do, honey. Just focus a little bit more on the contrast, because your life is really, really good. The worst part of life you've ever had is spectacular. But you're ready for more. So focus just a bit on some of the anomalies. Not the huge, big, nasty ones. Just a little bit. And as you focus on those contrasts, it will show you the simplest, easiest path to your bliss. Because when you have contrast, when you taste something and it needs seasoning, you don't have to pour the whole box of salt in. Just do it a little bit at a time. Taste and then adjust. Taste and adjust. Season appropriately. And don't wait to the very end to start seasoning. If you're in a process, if you're everything you add to the pot, season that thing as you go. So at the end of the day, it's always perfect. You don't have to kill it with salt or pepper, or it's so spicy enough to pop your head off. Y'all Texans, y'all like everything big and spicy. We do too. That's just wonderful. But see, temper your seasoning in every dynamic of your life, and do small gradient changes, and that will allow you the benefit of the focus that you're asking. And it's almost just a fine tuning. It's not like this major huge change, because you're right. You're already happy. But you're asking, I'm already happy, now how do I get happier? And how can my higher self help me? Well, your higher self already is. If you could focus on that just a little bit, then your higher self wouldn't have to wonder if you're going to allow the higher self to be able to help in your higher self reality that is your higher self. Then you wouldn't have to do all that. The higher self would already be at the dinner table congratulating you on this perfectly seasoned meal. Perfect.